Hello, Virgo, and welcome back. Thank you for joining me. And for any newcomers, I'd just like to introduce myself. My name's Jackie, and my channel is Romany Tarot. Okay, so Virgo, let's get on with the reading. I'd just like to thank any subscribers that have subscribed to my channel, and I really do appreciate it. So let's get on and let's have a look, see what's going on for you for the month of May, or just in general, Virgo, all right? So the first, the number that you have for this month is the number 9, and it has committed on this card. So feel very committed in some way. And we also have can be taken advantage of. So make sure you're not being taken advantage of, Virgo, all right? And the word that sticks out to me is this committed word. So let's have a look at number 9. Okay, so 9s are all about vision, all right? So it's the number of vision. If we're looking at Mars, then this is about your pursuit for what you want and how you go into battle, all right? So it's how you obtain what you want. All right, and if we're looking at the 9th house, this is about your higher mind education, all right? So it's educating ourselves. It also covers the house of religion, justice, law, and long-distance travel is number 9, all right? So with that, you do have the Hermit and the 10 of Coins. Let's just see if there's anything else. Okay, so if we're looking at this card, we're going by this third eye chakra here. You have this third eye chakra. This is your card, of course, Virgo, the Hermit. And this again as vision. So a very similar reading to Pisces, you know, sort of, they got the number 9, they got the Hermit, and they also got a couple of these cards, one of these cards here, engagement. So your opposite sign is Pisces. So for any of you that have a Pisces moon, I'll check out that reading, all right? Because quite similar. All right, so this is all seeing, the third eye chakra. So I see, seeing things a lot clearer. So it's having insight into something, a deeper understanding to what's going on and why, all right? So yeah, that covers all that sort of stuff. Okay, so let's have a look at your oracle cards that are pre-pulled. If we look at these cards here on this side. So first of all, we have from the Wisdom Oracle, we have Loyal Heart. So I do feel for some of you Virgos, there's somebody that's come into your life, that's in your life, or someone coming into your life, but I do feel that this is somebody you already know. I don't think for some of you, this is not quite a relationship yet, but someone that feels very loyal to you in some way, somebody who looks up to you in some way, someone who is impressed with you in some way, all right? And for others, this is generally a connection you have with someone where you really look up to each other and appreciate each other in some way, all right? So that is a lovely card, all right? So this is someone that has come into your life. And I'm going to go straight into these with that card because these are from the Romance Angels. So the first card that came out for you is Forgiving and Learning. So this says, as you release and heal the past, you experience more love in your present moments, all right? So don't think, I think for some of you, don't think that every relationship, everybody's different. But not every relationship is going to be the same, all right? So you have to, some of you have to learn to open your heart again, all right? Even if this is for, you know, some close friendships or, you know, getting closer to some of the people in your life, you know, sort of spending more time with them in some way, all right? So as you release and heal the past, you experience more love in your present moments, all right? So don't discard something that's trying to come in for you, all right? Because spirit is trying to guide you to somebody, I feel, here in some way. Okay, so your next card that you had was this could be the one. So yeah, this could be the one. You've already met the romantic partner you seek, all right? But are you seeing it? I'm seeing these like angels, two angels, 2 hours, be wise up, and see something when it's in front of you here in some way, all right? Because this actually could be the person for you. I do feel that you're quite different in some ways. Of course, it's not your usual person that you're used to. So, learn to, remember to learn from not every relationship is going to be, the same as what you've experienced in the past, right? So there's a need to forgive, there's a need to heal from the past here, all right? So this could be the one. So it's somebody you've already met. This could be, you could see this person, just as a friend at the moment for some of you. But there's something going on here and it goes a lot deeper, all right? And you also have the engagement card, which says your love life is ascending to a higher level of commitment, all right? So somebody wants something a little bit more with you. It may be, you don't feel rushed, that's what I want to say to you, because you have got the Hermit card there, so and you've got time for a nap. So, don't feel rushed into anything, take your time. As I say, no one's going anywhere at the moment. Okay, Virgo, so that's lovely. I like that. That's really nice. Just learn to trust again, learn to open yourself up to that sort of, this isn't going to be for everyone, but open yourself up to love here in some way, all right? Okay, so your next card that you have is time for a nap. So as I said, this card, I feel with the Hermit card, is asking you to maybe not rush anything. Especially in your work and business and stuff like that, go with the flow, take it in your strides. That's what I want to say. And for others of you, you're looking more deeper, because the number 9 also is a card of, as they say, it's religion, spirituality, all that stuff. So I feel you're looking into soul searching, looking into your spiritual life. But time for a nap. We could look at this another way as well. Are we, as I say, don't rush, of course, but are you sort of resting on something too long? That's what I want to say. Are you sort of taking your time on something that's taking too long? Could you be, taking this nap a little bit too much in your life in some way? I'm not saying you're sleeping all the time, of course I'm not, but it's just means that you sort of maybe just a little bit too laid back. But we'll see where that's coming. But for others of you, it's telling you that you need to that you're really concentrating on something here, because we do have committed here in this number 9. So you're really being committed here to something in your life, whether it's your job, your business, your hobby, your interests in some way. So you're really sort of looking into something. And remember also that number 9, the house of higher education, learning. So really studious, really studying something in detail. All right, Virgo. So let's have a look. In the future position here, you do have the blessed card. So being blessed here, being guided, as I said, and blessed. It is also the number 22, if that means anything to any of you. But just blessings coming in for you, Virgo, in your life, all right? Right, as I say, this is what you're aiming towards here, Virgo, this 10 of coins, all right? So it's about your financial stability, not just that, being stable in your life, having your own home, having, what you need, leaving a legacy here, sort of making some sort of imprint here. All right. So, so this is what it's all about, I think, here, is building a business, something that you can pass on, something that that will be, you will be remembered for in, years and years to come, generations here in some way. All right. So I'm open, as I always say, I hope I'm making sense. So that's really nice, Virgo. All right. So we're going to pull some tarot now. We're going to do the Celtic cross and see what we have. And let's just see what comes over for you. So let's just put those aside. So we're going to pull from the Art Nouveau. I think it's the Art Nouveau, yeah. Tarot. Make sure the right way up. Okay, so let's see what we have for you, Virgo, from the tarot. See what's coming in. Let's give them a good shuffle. What do we have for Virgo? Right, let's start. Okay, Virgo, so your situation now, whatever your energy is, wow, there we go, the Ace of Coins. All right, so really starting something here. This is an opportunity coming in, an offer of some sort, all right? So this is where you're at. For some of this is brand new. This could be a new job, a new relationship, could be both, you know, whatever it is for you. Something really nice is happening for you at the moment. And of course, you have the potential to learn about something, for something to grow, you know, sort of like planting that seed and making sure that you see something through here in some way, all right? So let's have a look. So let's have a look at your next card, which could be the challenge. All right, we do have the Tower. So this is the challenge, or maybe something that's stopping you. So the challenge at the moment is, I just feel for you, whatever's happening for you, Virgo, with this card, I feel, obviously it's sudden, it's very sudden. It's something that comes out of the blue. So something may, at the moment, be distracting you slightly, all right? From doing what you really love. I'll say what you really love doing, but this is another opportunity. It's something else that you're going to love doing, all right? So it doesn't mean to say that you can't do both things. So it won't surprise me if I don't see the Two of Coins come up in this reading. So, yeah, so you can multitask, believe it or not. It's just finding that time. Remember, time for a nap. Just finding that time and thinking about things with the Hermit of where you're going to fit things in. All right, I hope that makes sense. Okay, so let's have a look at the third card. So this is the distant past. All right, there we go. So we have this Piscean energy coming through here. And also, before I carry on, remember we're looking at Pluto here as well with the Tower. So it's starting from scratch, especially with the Ace of Coins. So starting something, something new, I think, from scratch. And yeah, being able to... I think pull it off here in some way, Virgo. All right, the Hangman in the past means that you've been hanging around too long. Remember, I did pick that sort of energy up there with time for a nap. So something that's taken a long time, something you've really had to look at carefully, something that you begin to understand. So it's taking you a little bit of time, I think, to sort of realise something, seeing something a lot clearer here with the Hangman. All right, so this is the past, distant past. So you've been doing this for a while, all right? And two majors here as well. So let's carry on to your fourth card. So this is the recent past. Wow. Okay, so here we have Jupiter, all right? So this is things are changing for you, Virgo. Things are starting to move. Starting to turn for you. Things are turning in your favor in some way with the Wheel of Fortune. Your luck is changing. Your destiny, you know, it's sort of jumping. It's knowing as well, knowing exactly what's going on around you. All right. This is a cycle. This is something that comes in. It's a chance. You know, there's a new chance here in some way of something that's come in recently. And you have a chance to sort of go for something here. So let's have a look at your fifth card. So what's on your mind? Your crown in position. So we do have, not only do you have the Ten of Coins, you have the Ten of Cups as well. All right. So this is, of course, this is what your this is on your mind, your money, you know, building up for yourself, having that stability and that happiness. You know what I mean? So also, you know, we're looking for some of you at families as well. So, you know, building a strong family, a strong unit here for yourself, all right? So this is about your future happiness, your financial stability, everything, all right? That is in your main focus, you know, making yourself comfortable, Virgo, all right? So let's have a look at your future position. I will pull these up a little bit. So let's have a look at your future position. What will be? Okay, so we do have the Six of Cups. So of course this is something. I think you may be returning to someone. I'm not saying this is a relationship, but something that you could have a meeting from someone from the past here in the future, or someone coming back into your life from the past. This could be an old friend, you know, whoever it is for you. But somebody is coming back into your life, all right? And it could be an apology as well. You know, someone coming in to say sorry about something and make something right here in some way. And as I say, it's not always about a past relationship or an ex-lover. This is about your past friendships or people you've been estranged to, you know, people coming back into your life, or somebody, you know, who wants to return to your life that you haven't seen in quite a while. All right. So let's have a look. So let's have a look at your seventh. What's next? Your seventh position. All right. So a decision here. All right. So this is something that you have got to think about. I did say the Two of Coins, but we have the Two of Swords. So something you've got to think about here, Virgo. It's not going to be easy. I do feel as well that you've been protecting your heart, making sure you don't get hurt again as well. But there's a need to take the blindfold off and sort of make a choice here, or make a decision here in some way of what you're going to do, or which way you're going to go here in some way. All right. So let's have a look at your environment. So what's around you, your environment. Okay, so intuition, the High Priestess. Someone, I think, intuitively feels your energy here. Somebody is really in your energy here. Also, Pisces energy, Pisces Cancer or Scorpio. But somebody is really in your energy here. They feel you. Go in some way energetically, they just feel you. That's just what I'm picking up here with this card. Because this is your environment, and of course it's your instincts as well, your feelings, your intuition. You know when something feels right, you know when something doesn't feel right, you know. So it covers both of them aspects. So let's have a look at your hopes and fears. See, Pisces got this card as well, the Three of Coins. Sorry, I keep mentioning Pisces, but that is coming up, so I would really check out that Pisces reading. The Three of Coins, being diligent, being skillful in some way, trying to finish something, starting something, finishing it, making sure, you know, this is attention to detail, the Three of Coins, you know, really, and people admiring you as well, and sort of taking on board what you're doing. And really appreciating what you're doing, all right? And asking, you know, asking you for advice, asking you for help. What do you think? What do you think we should do? Or just looking at your work and really, you know, admiring it in some way, all right? So don't fear that. So as I say, this is what you hope, you know, this is all what we hope is happening as well. So, know that you're appreciated here, Virgo, all right? Although maybe you feel, because this is in your hopes and fears, so maybe you feel that you're not appreciated, maybe you feel that you're not being noticed, but you are, you really are, Virgo, all right? So let's have a look at your outcome position. Now, this is your potential outcome, or what happens. So what happens? So there could be some disappointment in the future. Of course, we're facing some sort of disappointment. Maybe it could be so very small. It's nothing too big. But I feel this is you feeling that you could be doing something more. That's the feeling I'm getting from this Four of Cups. You feel you could be just doing something more. You know, just realise, Virgo, that what you're doing is enough. You know, you can only do so much. And whatever you're doing, you know, you just do what you can each time. It doesn't matter, all right? So maybe there's another offer. There could be another offer coming in, but you just haven't got the energy. Remember, time for a nap. You just haven't got the energy to take on anything else at the moment. That's the sort of energy I'm picking up with this card. So although it's a card of feeling bored, disappointed, feeling a little bit low, you know, because remember that the cups are all about our emotions. But I just generally feel that you just can't handle anything too much at the moment. It's like you just need to do one thing at a time at this particular time, all right? But let's pull another card on that and see what we have. Yeah, something, you've got the seven. You've got the seven of wands here, all right? So this is about standing your ground, putting up boundaries as well. So if you've been, you know, overloaded here in some way, remember to stand your ground and put up some boundaries here and just make somebody or, you know, whatever clear that there's only so much you can do. That's just what I'm feeling with these cards anyway, all right? So that's what I have for you, Virgo. So, yeah, and of course, we at the bottom of the deck, you've got the world. Remember the end of the cycle, beginning of a new one, completion. And you have the four of wands, a celebration. So you're going to have reason to celebrate here going into the future, all right? Some sort of celebration. I'll say make sure that you don't get any unwanted guests as well. Someone you could do without. Okay, that just popped into my head. Sorry about that, all right? Okay, Virgo, that's what I have for you. I do hope you enjoyed the reading. And if you did, don't forget, if you can, subscribe. It helps to grow the channel. Please give me a thumbs up if it did resonate with you. It's not going to resonate with everyone, of course. And most importantly, please do hit that notification bell so that you'll be informed when I do further readings that come up. So I do only do monthly readings at the moment, and I do occasional yearly. I pull out a year very occasionally. So, yeah, so don't forget, do, you know, whatever it is that you're dealing with, which looks very nice. You've got a lovely spread here. So I do wish you all the best of luck, and take care of yourself. I'll see you soon for your June readings. Okay, Virgo, thank you for listening, and I'll be back soon. Bye.